Our work concerns mechanosensory hair cells, which are the receptor cells of hearing imbalance. Hearing loss in humans is often due to death of these sensory receptor cells. Hair cells are susceptible to death from a variety of sources, including noise, exposure to therapeutic drugs with ototoxic side effects, and aging. One of the major questions under consideration in our lab right now is what are the cellular and molecular mechanisms that determine whether a hair cell under stress ultimately lives or dies? Our studies utilize an in vitro model preparation of whole organ cultures of utricles from adult mice. The utricle is a vestibular organ, and hair cells of the utricle are similar in both structure and function to hair cells of the cochlea, which is the hearing organ. This schematic shows the utricle sensory epithelium, and the hair cells are shown here in blue. And you can see that each hair cell is completely surrounded by these glia-like supporting cells, which are shown here in green. The utricle model system is the best characterized in vitro model of hair cells and supporting cells from an adult mammal. And we use this model system to examine the death and survival of hair cells exposed to ototoxic drugs, including the anti-cancer drug cisplatin and the aminoglycoside antibiotics. This study focuses on heat shock proteins, which are molecular chaperones that can be rapidly induced in response to stress and which are protective in a wide variety of systems. We had shown previously that induction of heat shock proteins has a robust protective effect against hair cell death caused by both cisplatin and the aminoglycoside antibiotics. We also knew that HSP70 in particular is both necessary and sufficient for this protective effect. In this paper, we have examined the molecular mechanisms underlying the protective effect of HSP70. We first examined the localization of HSP70 following heat shock, and we were surprised to find that HSP70 is not actually induced in hair cells at all. The HSP70, which is schematized here as these red triangles, is actually induced exclusively in the supporting cells and not in the hair cells, suggesting that the supporting cells may act as protectors when hair cells are under stress. To test this directly, we utilized an adenoviral-based method that we had previously developed to specifically infect supporting cells of the utricle without infecting hair cells. This method is described in the paper. We used adenovirus to drive expression of HSP70 exclusively in supporting cells and found that HSP70 in supporting cells protects hair cells against death caused by exposure to aminoglycoside antibiotics. We started thinking about ways in which HSP70 in the supporting cell might protect the hair cell. And one hypothesis that we decided to test was that HSP70 might actually be secreted by the supporting cell, and that this secreted HSP70 might promote survival of the hair cell, and that this protection might or might not require internalization of HSP70 by the hair cell. This hypothesis makes several very specific predictions. First, it predicts that HSP70 should be present in the media. Second, it predicts that if we apply exogenous HSP70 to the media, that should be protective as well. Thirdly, it predicts that co-culture of heat-shocked utricles with non-heat-shocked utricles should be protective. And finally, it predicts that tagged HSP70 should translocate from supporting cells to hair cells. We tested each of these predictions in the paper, and we found that by ELISA, HSP70 is indeed present in the media surrounding heat-shocked utricles. We also found that if we exogenously applied HSP70 to the media, that also protected hair cells against aminoglycoside-induced death. The lead author on the paper is Lindsey May, a very talented biologist in my laboratory, and she will describe her experiments to test the second two predictions of this hypothesis.
For the co-culture experiments, I utilized these Transwell inserts. The bottom has a mesh with an 8-micron pore size, and it fits in a 24-well culture plate to form a basket. This allows me to culture two sets of utricles, one in the top basket and one in the bottom. And while these two sets of utricles do not touch, they share the same media and therefore the ability to share secreted molecules. For my first experiment, I heat-shocked utricles and placed them in the top basket. I placed non-heat-shocked utricles in the bottom basket, and they shared the same culture media containing the aminoglycoside antibiotic gentamicin, which is toxic to hair cells. We found the heat-shocked utricles to be partially protected against gentamicin-induced hair cell death. We also found the non-heat-shocked utricles to be protected as well. This showed us that something secreted by the heat-shocked utricles is protective. To test whether HSP70 is required for this protective effect, I repeated the co-culture, this time using utricles from an HSP70 knockout mouse in the top basket. When heat-shocked, we found the protective effect for the heat-shocked utricles themselves and the co-cultured utricles underneath to be abolished. This showed us that HSP70 is required for the protective effect. For my final co-culture experiment, I went back to wild-type utricles. This time, I used an HSP70 function-blocking antibody in the media. When I depleted the media of HSP70 using the function-blocking antibody, we found the protective effect for the heat-shocked utricles and the co-culture utricles to be abolished. This showed us that HSP70 is required in the media for the protective effect. We performed several experiments to test whether HSP70 is internalized by hair cells. One of the experiments is shown here. I used an adenovirus to drive HSP70 with an M-cherry fusion protein. I infected supporting cells of the utricle and examined M-cherry signal over time. At no time did we find HSP70 M-cherry localized to the hair cells, suggesting that HSP70 is not internalized by hair cells.
Our data indicate that supporting cells secrete HSP70, and that this extracellular HSP70 protects hair cells against aminoglycoside-induced death. It appears that this protection does not require internalization of HSP70 by the hair cells. Together, our data suggest a major role for these glia-like supporting cells in determining whether a hair cell under stress ultimately lives or dies. And they suggest that these glia-like supporting cells may represent a good target for therapies aimed at preventing or reversing hearing loss.